here, Rufus?
Oh, you know my name. Oh, can I call you Daddy?
You can if you wish. But Officer Newton works as well.
Bit of a mouthful. Sexiest striptease I've ever seen.
How does it feel around here? You feeling the while to give up, yes?
Bigger men than you have tried.
I may not be large in stature, but I'm larger in faith. You see, you don't have the faith of the CDC. You don't have the faith of what we can do.
Oh, I've got faith in you being a bunch of other cockbags. Oh, that one actually had a bit of punch behind it. Oh, I'm proud.
I do like gloves, don't you?
Oh, yes.
They're very effective. Mm-hmm. They protect you, but they can also deal harm. Don't you think?
Oh, you just missed my nipple, that one.
Feel willing to talk yet?
Sure. Yeah. Yeah.
Go on then.
Harder, Daddy, harder.
It's a shame I don't have my knife on me.
What, you can twitch play as well, you kinky fucker?
No, I was going to cut your bollocks off.
Oh, well. What a pity.
However, I do have a gun. And I can simply shoot them off.
Yes, so efficient though.
Yes, but it makes so much more mess.
Yeah, but with that comes the risk of extreme shock, blood loss, and oh, that might kill me. And I never get to the information you want.
That's why I've got a doctor coming. Now where the fuck is that doctor?
He's right here, sir.
Bring him in!
No need to push. I'm quite conversant with the use of doors. Thank you very much.
Oh, well, there's no question here who is the patient, is there?
He had a little accident.
Yes, they always do. Come on, my boy. Sit yourself up.
I'm surprised he's still conscious.
Looks like you've been at him for quite a while.
Not that long. I don't have much in the way of patience.
Shitty doctor yourself.
Men with guns seldom do.
I can tell you one thing. There's a certain woman out there who's going to be really pissed off what you've just done.
That was the intent, my dear boy.
About 15 minutes.
15 minutes?
Well, you should last a little bit longer than that, present company allowing.
Well, I simply need the information out of him, and then I was going to execute him.
Oh, you're there, fun.
I wasn't having absolutely no intention of being fun.
Well, then, if you wish him to actually say anything to you, then clearly it's time for you to go and get a couple of cups of hot tea and a plate of biscuits.
And why on earth would I do that?
He's dehydrated, that's completely obvious. He must have been sat there for any amount of time. He's on the verge of exhaustion. So we shall rehydrate him with a cuppa, and maybe some biscuits will loosen his tongue, because I normally find that people become so much more chatty over a good cuppa and a good sweet biscuit. So...
Oh, you're much better than the other one.
You're a revolutionary, are you?
I'm revolutionary good looking, yes.
Well, what made you so revolting, eh?
I like you.
What brings you to this place of being sat in a chair beaten up by somebody who's clearly enjoying it?
Beaten up by other people dressed like him who enjoy it.
So, there are many revolutionaries, are you?
Oh no, there's just many CEC officers trying to beat me up.
So you're revolting against him?
No, I just thought I could walk on back to die. It's discrimination, I tell you.
Excellent, yes. Place him here. Obviously you're not going to be able to trust up like this, and you've got a gun, haven't you? So,
Oh, I did. I don't think I've misplaced it.
Snip. Snip. There. Sip slowly.
One false move and this bullet goes through your head.
And you wouldn't want that before a jammy dodger. There, so you're revolting against him.
He's just revolting.
He thinks you don't like the colour of his skin.
No, I just don't like him.
And so,
we've got t-shirts.
Pray tell, if this revolution succeeds, if you overthrow the CDC, what then? What's your grand plan to replace it with?
I haven't got a plan like that. Do you think I'm the person to plan ahead?
It's always the same with revolutions. Smash this, destroy that, overthrow everything, drag down the people in charge, bound them up against the wall, presumably. Never a plan of what comes next. No thoughts, no replacement, no philosophy, no humanity.
Well, with the amount of money we're spending on repelling this rebellion, we could have been making everyone's lives a lot better.
Your own lives, you're more like.
I would suggest that you spend a bit more time thinking carefully about what you could bring to the party that would be better than what this gentleman has to offer.
Well, for instance, I have a gun. I have that to offer. What do you have? Some weird kinks and a sharp wit?
That's fucking awesome.
He has some good biscuits.
Let's rephrase that. I have those good biscuits.
Yeah,
mine.
And, however, with coffee like this, I can understand why there's a revolution.
Revolution over a coffee?
Yep.
How pathetic.
I've known worse.
Next you're going to be telling me there's revolution over the air we breathe.
So how is it?
Yeah, there is another revolutionary group out there that does that, though they're not very, they're not really the popular front of us.
Pray tell, in your recent revolutionary activities, have you come across two young people? Stephen and Sarah? No. They're acquaintances of mine. We have been separated. Apparently there's a war on.
Could have fooled me.
And a revolution. They're separate things, I trust.
Yes.
So it must get a bit complex. Do you have, like, you know, coats of different colours, flags? That's fairly traditional.
I'm not the fashion department.
Who do you tell? Who is your enemy and who is your friend? Especially if you're all wandering around in hoods. Must make it rather difficult to tell who is the good guys and who is not.
Well, it's easy enough, like, you know, dickheads like him. Clearly the bad guys. I mean, look, who else wears, you know, as much black as possible?
I do. I enjoy the amount of black. It means the blood doesn't show up.
Is it also because you've got no fashion sense and don't know which colours to match?
Well, as you can see, green goes pretty damn well with it. And a little trace of gold.
Did your mummy buy that one for you?
Actually, she did. Before she passed away.
Oh, yeah, I wonder why she wasn't moving much last night.
If I remember rightly, it was by the hands of some rebellion.
You should put more coffee in your mouth and have less insults coming out of it. Unless you enjoy the pain.
Never let it be said that I don't like a good time.
But still, other than torturing prisoners, what do you look forward to when this rebellion and war are at an end?
Finally, a little bit of peace and quiet.
Ah, wouldn't that be nice? Everybody longs for peace and quiet, and yet, somehow, we never seem to receive it.
That was almost genuine.
Oh. Ah, fuck! Ah! Introduced.
Pleased to meet you.
Yes,
sir. I am the doctor.
Thank you very much.
And this is your friend?
Yes, it is.
If you happen to see two young people called Stephen and Sarah in your travels, do please treat them kindly. They are not rebels or revolutionaries or anything in this war.
Let's find your novices. Yeah. They'll be pleased to see you again.
Oh, God, my bullets!
Young man, I will return one day. I will come and see what, if anything, you put in place after the revolution. I hope that her faith in you means it'll be something better.
Don't you worry about that.
I'm still kind of dead.